couple of people asked what a bassoon was or what was up, so I thought I have to play it.
Oh,
so this is for, because some people, have you guys not seen one before?
I think I've heard like the orchestras play it before, but I've never actually seen it up close.
Yeah, so this is what it looks like. Somebody was asking earlier how old it was. This one, particular one's from 1927. Germany. You're asking about this. The metal piece is it's a double reed, so it's two pieces of wood, basically.
Yeah.
Folded over. It's the same principle as if you like put grass.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
So it just makes that weird
screech noise. Yeah.
Yeah. And the last like cool fun fact about the bassoon is that it looks normal. When you look at the front of the instrument, like the clarinet or whatever, but when you flip it around the backside, it like goes nuts. So I've got nine keys for my left thumb, four for my right thumb.
So,
when I'm doing school shows with kids, I'm like, it's just like video games.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true. Because anything's possible then.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna play. I've got one piece that I was working on this week.
Does the different mouthpiece give you different tones?
A little bit, yeah. And so I made them all too. They're all made.
Okay.
All the double reeds, the players and the bassoon players are made by hand. So the piece that I worked on, like my kind of one of the two projects I worked on here, is learning this piece. It's by a woman named Jocelyn Morlock. She's from Canada. She unfortunately just died very young, 53 year or two ago. The piece is written for bassoon and harp. Obviously, there's no harp here, so I just spent this week learning the part. So I'm going to play the first three quarters or so of it, because the last page is mostly me just holding long notes and the harp doing her thing. So I'm not going to do that part. So I'll just play this. And a little bit about Jocelyn Morlock. She was a really like up-and-coming composer. She won a Juno Award for her piece. I'm blanking on the name of it. Oh, my name is, and then I forgot the name. But it was actually inspired by a young woman who took her own life after being cyberbullied. And then somebody approached Jocelyn, and she worked with the family and created this piece. And that won a Juno Award, which is basically like Canada's Grammys, I think. This piece, Night Song, is called Night Song, and she writes that it's an evocation of secretive nocturnal solitude. She talks about curiosity, loneliness, and conflict, alternating with peace and contemplation and introversion. So that's kind of what she was thinking of, I guess, when she wrote this. So here's the bassoon part of Night Song.